Welcome back to another episode. Here today with another video. Let's get started.
Really? No, that's you. Sorry.
Really?
Besides, the only reason you don't have a girlfriend is because you just weren't motivated to get one, right?
He's the world's class baby face.
So let's use this as an excuse to finally get you one.
Ooh, are you working on your Okazaki magic? I'm kind of starting to feel enthusiastic now.
Alright, let's do our best then. Looks like I've found something to alleviate my boredom for a while.
That wasn't so bad, our fate.
We get to work as soon as the school's over. Alright, let's walk around the school and see if we can find a girl who looks like she might be able to help.
I'm getting excited now.
A dumb grin is plastered on his face.
Dumb grin.
No doubt he's been fantasizing about it all during class.
So, who will go with? An underclassman that couldn't ever refuse us? Yeah, I say we just pick someone who will do whatever we want. If we just threaten her a little. What?
You like, no matter what, underhanded tactics are all this guy can think of. Threaten is like kind of pretend to beat her up or whatever.
Oh.
That said, it's not like we can just ask a random stranger to do this for him. I was right, this isn't going to be easy. Who should I ask?
Go with someone else, because the Fujibayashi twins are like, one of them is really shy and the other one is like beating up Sunara.
Yeah.
So.
A girl we can ask other than the Fujibayashi sisters.
Fujibayashi.
I suppose there's Furuoka. We haven't seen each other ever since that rainy day. It would be a bit hard to ask her. Try someone else. Oh yeah, there's Tomio, I forgot.
Go with... wait. Do we know anybody else other than Tomio?
Tomio might be pretty good. She does like us.
No, but isn't Tomio that... Tomio is also the other one that beats up Tsunami.
Yeah, she's like that ninja girl.
Yeah, she's the ninja girl.
But she's friends with us. She might do it.
She wouldn't do it for Sunahara, though.
She'd do it for me, maybe. For Tomiya. I don't know how many other people we know. We know some crazy people, like the girl with the knife.
You mean the carving?
Yeah.
She does the star thing. Okay, go with Tomio.
Let's go with Tomio.
Are you serious?
He kind of likes her anyway. He keeps talking to her. Yeah, I'm completely serious. She's got a good figure, and she's quite pretty. And she's more than qualified to be your girlfriend.
If only looks are all I have to worry about.
Wait, are you scared?
Are you calling me scared?
That's a mean stutter you got there.
I'm not scared.
No, you're totally scared.
I'll just take deep breaths and I'll be fine. Okay. I will bear a healthy child.
Yeah, you totally messed up right now.
Does it seem that way? It's awfully strange.
Idiot, you're supposed to be self-assured in this kind of situation.
Self-assured? What are we talking about? When were we talking about Tomio?
You really don't get it, do you? You two have been each other's fateful rivals up till now, right?
Maybe.
As people who acknowledge each other's strength, you will be able to cooperate whenever something bigger than you two of you occurs. Like, let's say you're walking down the hallway and you bump into each other. It'll go like this.
What's this? You seem unusually troubled. That's none of your business. That's true. However, I don't want to see you get beaten up by someone other than me. Who do you think is going to get beaten up? I can fight you right here, right now. Maybe so. Well, see ya. Wait up. You should just be honest to begin with. I'll probably be... I'm probably the strongest ally you've got. Oh, that sounds good.
Right, so then it's settled. Let's go. Post haste.
What does that mean?
Fast as possible.
Oh.
Accompanied by Tsunahara, who is in high spirits, we head towards the second year classroom.
Wait, what are we? What classroom are we?
Going to Tomoya's classroom.
Yeah, but what classroom are we?
I don't know.
Ah,
there she is. I think we're like final year, you know, we're about to graduate. After waiting for a while in front of the classroom for our chance, Tomoya comes out, holding a bag in her hand. Keep up the bravado no matter what, all right? You're supposed to be her worthy rival after all.
Yeah, I get it. Well, I'll be off now.
He walks into Tomoya triumphantly.
Bam.
They lightly bump shoulders. She wipes the shoulder she ran into with him and continues on walking.
Hey, don't ignore me. I'm in a hurry. Don't wipe your clothes off like I'm something filthy. Okazaki, are you about to go home? She talked to us.
You too, huh? Want to walk up to the school gates together?
Quit ignoring me, you two. This isn't how things should be. Told you. She doesn't like Tsunahara. Two rivals just bumped into each other. Shouldn't there be something more than this?
Wait.
I can't be wasting time with every idiot I bump into.
Yeah, but Okazaki might ask her on his behalf to do this thing.
Yeah.
Indeed.
Or he's probably just going to be really mean and not ask at all. And why are you agreeing with her? What's up with this guy?
Oh well, why don't you at least listen to what he has to say for a bit?
I'm really busy, so could you keep this brief? So when you look at me, how would you say I'm doing? I'd say you're happy-go-lucky as always. What? I obviously look troubled. All right. So you were troubled by something?
Probably wanting to just get this over with quickly. She goes along with him and with a weary face.
That's none of your business. That sounds just about right. See you then. Wait, you're supposed to say I don't want to see you getting beaten up by someone other than me here. I think just about anyone can beat you up, though. I'm begging you, just say it. Just this once, all right?
She takes a fleeting glance at her watch and takes a short breath.
I don't want to see you getting beaten up by someone other than me. Who you're saying is gonna get beaten up? I could fight you right here, right now. If you're picking a fight, then just say so from the beginning. Okay, I let this idiot take up my time. I have to hurry.
She takes a look at her watch one more time, then runs away.
This didn't go well at all, did it?
I guess you still haven't got added enough with her to qualify as rivals. It'll probably go well if you fight her with 50 more time. Or fight with her around 50 more times.
I'd die before I get that far. She just didn't have enough time.
April 25th, Friday. I arrived at the school during recess after third period. I laze about in the classroom. Before I know it, it's lunch break. Tsunahara walks in with a heavy gait and a depressed look on his face. Hey, what's wrong? Why the eyes like a dead fish?
That's a nice way of wording it. And whose fault do you think it is that I'm like this right now?
I do wonder.
It's yours!
But you know...
Yeah, it's my own fault, because there's no happiness in my life. Damn it!
At least it's better when I...
At least it's better when I say it myself rather than having someone else say it.
But, you know, I wonder if there's someone tone deaf could actually become a rapper, is what I was going to say, though.
So it wasn't ever related?
Even.
So it wasn't even related? Seriously, whatever. I don't care anymore. My little sister's going to be here tomorrow, and she's actually going to... to see me living my unhappy life. For Waka.
Somehow I'm pitting him tremendously right now. Alright. In that case, let's do our best and look for someone else today.
Told you. Okay.
Well, if there was one problem with our method of finding a girlfriend yesterday, I crumple up my bread wrapper and throw it in the garbage bin as I speak to him. I'd say it was we asked someone who already knew you.
You're saying we'd be better off by asking someone who doesn't know me? Like for Waka.
Right, someone who's completely clueless would be best.
Well, I suppose some people might have preconceptions about me. I guess that's what we get for being delinquents.
Though it'll be far better for them if they just lived out their lives without ever once knowing of your existence.
I'm now really starting to think it was a mistake to rely on you for this.
Don't worry now, just believe in me. After the bell signaling the end of school rings, we head down to the courtroom.
You really think we can find someone here?
There are very few people walking around.
For Waka's walking around.
Well, aren't the people in the school building all going to be with their friends?
Well, I suppose there are a lot of girls walking around here alone. Okazaki, how about that girl over there? She's going to be one of the twins. Let's go, Godspeed.
Sunohara, wait. What do you plan on saying to her?
Huh? I'm just going to ask her.
Ah, you really are such an idiot, such a dumbass, such a loser.
I don't think that last part was relevant here.
I mean, how are you planning on just suddenly asking someone to be your girlfriend? You gotta use your head a little bit and try starting up a conversation more indirectly.
What are you saying I should do then?
Listen up, in this situation, what you should do is... I take a short breath and I open my mouth. Tell them it's a job.
What do you mean?
You're gonna scare them away if you suddenly ask them to pretend to be your girlfriend. So don't you feel that there'd be more understanding if you just told them you have a job for them involving that?
That means I'd also have to pay them money. I don't got any money, because you spend it all on pickles.
You could just lie and tell them that they're getting paid. You're just going to use your amazing charms and make them fall madly in love with you anyway, right?
Money.
Pretty much.
So come on, let's have you rehearse your lines.
Yeah, sure.
He clears his throat a couple times, then calls out to me with a smile.
Hey girl, I got a nice job for you. How about it?
Whoa.
That does sound like it might work.
Right? But it's probably better that you tell them about the pay first. Try having her do it for 10,000 yen.
Hey girl, how about you do this job for me for 10,000 yen? Is that $100? Isn't 10,000 yen a bit expensive?
Yeah, it's $100. Then why don't you try asking her how much she wants?
Makes sense. Well then. Hey girl, how much to do a job for me?
Why don't you admit the job part?
Hey girl, how much?
Make them feel your manliness too. Use a rough tone of voice, that'd be perfect. And it's also better if you tell them it won't take very long, and that all they have to do is stand there. If you do just that, you'll get her, no problem.
Alright, well I'll go try it out then.
He gives me a quick thumbs up, and goes off towards an underclassman that was walking around.
Hey, Missy. Yes? What is it? How much? Huh? Like I said, how much? I don't quite... Come on, it's fine. It won't take long. Just stay still and it'll be over real quick. Could it be you? You want me to... Come on, it's no big deal. It ain't time to be stingy. I'm sorry.
The girl runs away as fast as her legs will take her.
Wait, I just look like a pervert right now. He only realizes that when he says it out loud.
Nah, you don't just look like a pervert. You are a pervert right now.
Could you please not make me do this if you knew this was going to happen?
Well, that was just a little joke on my part.
Okay, well, I'm going to end the episode here. See you guys next time on Clan Ed. Bye.
Thanks for watching. See ya.